Hi everyone, here we are on our second video. Where we left off last time, I was using 3 pounds of brown clay, and I've changed my mind, and we're going to use 2.5 pounds of white stoneware clay. It's a very nice clay. It's easy to use. It's easy to work with. It's got a much finer grit in it, and it gives you beautiful results. So here we are at the wheel. On the pottery wheel, we have 2 pins, and those pins line up with this bat, and this bat is used to hold your piece whilst you're spinning. So you put the bat on, and when you're finished, you just take the bat right off with your piece. It's awesome. Works really well. So what we're going to do is we're going to put just a little bit of water in the center of the bat, just to dampen it, and then we're going to take our clay that's been formed into a nice round ball, and we're going to put it in the center as best we can, and then we're going to go for it. The most important thing to do when you're doing pottery is you got to center it, and you got to center it on the wheel. If you don't center it, you'll have nothing but wobbles and never get it lined up straight, and so it's absolutely vital that your piece be completely centered. So let's just give that a go. Now when you've got it centered, always keep lots of water on your hands here. When it is centered, your hands they'll just stop moving. One here. Just a little nervous. Hang on, bear with me. There we go. There, got it. Oh, sometimes it isn't easy. Okay, so now we got it on the got it centered on the bat, and you always want to keep your area clean, your piece clean. Make sure you can see what's happening to the clay, and after a little while you get to feel the clay, and when you get to do that, things start to really work for you. So anyway, the next step is we're going to open it up, and by opening it up, we're going to take our two thumbs, and we're going to let them find the center of the clay, and then we're going to just push down, and you're going to push down to as far as you want, depending on how much you want on the bottom. That's still a little bit too much, so we'll go down just a little bit, and then we're going to test. Where's my pin? I'm going to take the pin, and we're going to go down in the center of the pot and just poke it all the way to the bat, and that shows me that's about 3/4 of an inch, so we still got lots. I want to go down about 1/2 an inch. So there we go. That's about right. Now you want to make sure that you're cleaning off that water and that grog all the time. Okay, so the next step we're going to do is we're going to pull it apart. We're gonna make the walls smaller and make the base a little bit bigger. So you're pulling from the inside out and you're supporting with the right hand, and you just keep pulling to however long you wanna big you want the bottom. So we're gonna pull. Okay, we'll say that's about good enough. That's nice and not that big, but we're just gonna make a vase of some sort. Okay, so now we've pulled it open, everything is still good to go. Now we want to pull it up. We're gonna lift the clay up. So again, supporting with your inside and pushing in with your right hand will make your clay go straight up. So you want to do that until you're ready to form the piece. You don't want to be trying to form the piece and pulling up at the same time. So you want to pull up as far as you want, whatever you are looking at making. So we'll just pull some more. Trying to keep everything centered. And we'll keep going. Cleaning the water out from the inside of your pot, making sure you don't have any standing water in there. Okay, we're going to keep going. As you can notice, I'm always resting my left hand on my right hand so that they come up as close as they can together. Sometimes you have to let go and just do it, but it's a good way to start. We're going to go one more time, very slowly. Let's turn the wheel down a bit. Patience. But it's so much fun. Okay, here we go. We're going to try a little bit more. Slow things down a bit. push out the center a little bit. Make sure the center is, or the bottom is compressed. Excuse me. Well, let's make, change that a little bit. Bring it up just a little. Water in there. Well, that's the first one, folks. But before I go, I dropped my pen or my trimmer. We're going to just put a bottom on this. This has an indentation that goes in, so it'll give it a nice rounded finish on the bottom. Now, there's so many things you can do at this time. You can do all kinds of decorating. And maybe, no, maybe we'll just leave it like that. I'll keep you posted as we keep going. So the final step to throwing is, after you've done what you want to do and everything's finished, you have to cut the piece off from the bat. Cut the clay off from the bat. So the way you do that is you just lay your wire on the bat, push down, and just let it go, and it slices it underneath. And there you go. We've got a finished piece. I'll keep you posted as to its progress when I do something on it, and we'll go from there. We'll see who gets this one. And don't forget, my shop is Jude's Pots, JUDES-POTS.myshopify.com. And I have the shop on Etsy, and we're on YouTube and Facebook. I appreciate all your shares, and I'll start getting ready for the next video. Hope you have a great day, and thanks for watching.